I'm going to show you guys how to find the interval convergence of this power series by using the ratio test. So let's go ahead and indicate that this right here is our an. And let me just put this down right here for you guys. We will be doing this by the ratio test, right? And by the ratio test, we know that the first step is to take the limit as n goes to infinity. And let me just write this down right here for you guys, as n goes to infinity. If you write this down this way, you don't have to write down the lim so many times, right? This is also legitimate. And for the ratio test, we know we have to do the absolute value of an plus 1 over an, right? But that's the same as saying absolute value of an plus 1 times 1 over an. And now we just have to figure out an expression for an plus 1. And to do that, we just have to plug in n plus 1 into all the n's here. So we will first have, plugging n plus 1 into here, we will have 2 to the negative parentheses with n plus 1 inside now. And that's also plugging n plus 1 into this n. And this is also a numerator, so we have parentheses x minus 1 to the n plus 1 power. And all this is over, we're plugging n plus 1 into this n, so we have n plus 1 in red, and then plus another 1 in black, like that. And now we multiply by the reciprocal of an. Well, this was on the bottom earlier, now it will be on the top. So we have the n plus 1 on the top, over this and that will go down to the denominator. So we will have 2 to the negative n times x minus 1 to the n's power, just like this. Okay, to continue, you see right here, we can distribute the negative right here. So this is the same as saying 2 to the negative n minus 1, which you can use the rule of exponent to say that this is the same as 2 to the negative n times 2 to the negative 1, isn't it? And we can do the same thing right here. X minus 1 to the nth power first times x minus 1 to the first power. And on the bottom here, of course, we can say that's n plus 2. And now you can see the cancellations. Here we have 2 to the negative n. This can be canceled with this, right? Likewise, x minus 1 to the n, this can be canceled with that. So these are the cancellations. And let's put down equal sign. As you can see, I'm still just putting down equal sign because we are just doing algebra to simplify things, right? We haven't done the limits yet. Okay, what I would suggest you guys to do next is, so let's first put down all the numbers and all the things that has the n first. And you see this right here, it has the x minus 1. It has the x. Let's put that at the end, okay? All right, so I will see that this right here is 2 to the negative 1. That's the same as 1 half, right? And then this right here is n plus 1, so that's the numerator n plus 1, just like this. And this right here is on the bottom, so we put down n plus 2, like that. All this are just the number and also the terms with n. And this is multiplied with this, which is the x minus 1. And they are still in the absolute value, just like that, okay? And now we are ready to take the limit. And the limit-wise, it's just n goes to infinity, right? That's why I tell you guys to put down all the things involved at the n and also the constant multiple first. So we focus on this part and take the limit. Well, as you can see, on the top, we just care about 1 times n, so let me indicate this in blue. And on the bottom, we just care about 2 times n, right? So you know, this right here will go to 1 half, right? We are taking limit already, so we are going to change this to an arrow. This expression is approaching to 1 half, so let's put that down, and just a positive 1 half. I don't need the absolute value around that 1 half. But we will still put the x minus 1 in the absolute value, because x, you know, can be positive or negative, right? So this is the result of what we have after we have done the limit, right? Once again, this is what we have when we have done the limit from the ratio test. And you have to remember, when we're using the ratio test, if this is the result of the limit, we have to make sure that we set this to be less than 1 in order for us to have a convergent series, isn't it? So we set this to be less than 1, and we can do a few more steps in this case, because as you can see, we can multiply both sides by 2. So we can get absolute value of x minus 1 is less than 2 times 1, which is 2, like this. And when you have the absolute value of 1x, like this, minus or plus a number, this is the desired expression that you want. And you see we have less than 2, so this is perfect because I can tell you two important things. First, this number 2 is going to tell us the radius of convergence of the power series. And right here, we have 1x minus 1. You have to be sure that the coefficient of x right here, it has to be 1. When we have this situation, this 1, it's a center. So let me indicate that right here. The center is positive 1. Because you have to remember, it's the absolute value of x minus a, and the a is the 1 in our case, and that's the radius. So what does this mean? I can illustrate that with a number line for you guys. All right? So on the number line, first of all, let me mark it right here. This is my 1. And when the radius of the convergence is 2, this means I can go to the left 2 units, and if you go to the left 2 units, you end up with negative 1, right? Because 2. If you do 1 minus 2, you get negative 1. And now if you move from the center to the right 2 units, you end up with 3. Okay, so it seems that we care about negative 1 to 3, but the issue is that we don't know anything about the endpoints, in the sense that I'm not sure if you will converge at negative 1, I'm not sure if you will converge at 3, okay? At the moment, let me just put this down for you guys. This is my special type of interval notation. Because this right here should help you to remind you that we have to check the convergence at the endpoints, right? So that's why I have this right here, which doesn't make any sense at the moment, because we don't know what will happen right here and right there, right? Okay, to continue, as I said, we will be checking the endpoints, right? So let me just write this down right here for you guys. Let's go ahead and check when x is equal to negative 1. So what this means is that I'm going to plug in negative 1 into this x, and then I will produce another series based on the value when x is equal to negative 1. And I will have to see if that series converges or not. That's how you check the convergence at the endpoints. OK, so we will have the sum when n goes from 0 to infinity. And this is 2 to the negative n over n plus 1. And I will plug in negative 1 into this x. So we have parentheses, negative 1, minus 1, and then raised to the nth power. And now we can just do do some more algebra right here. This is going to be sigma when n goes from 0 to infinity. Allow me to write down the following. This right here is 2 to the negative n, which is the same as 1 over 2 to the past the n, isn't it? And then we have this factor here, n plus 1. OK, so let me just put this down right here for you guys. And this right here is what? Minus 1 minus 1, which is negative 2, like this, right? Negative 2 to the nth power, which is the same as saying, let me just write this down in detail, or let me write this down in red. It's the same as saying negative 1 to the nth power times 2 to the nth power, isn't it? Once again, we have negative 2 inside. Negative 2 to the nth power, which is the same as saying negative 1 to the nth power first, and then 2 to the nth power. Right? And the reason I want to do this for you guys is that, as we can see, 2 to the n here can be canceled with this 2 to the n, so that's extremely nice. So all in all, we have the series as n goes from 0 to infinity, and let's put this down first. We have the negative 1 in the parentheses to the nth power, and then let's write down the 1 over n plus 1, like that. Okay, what kind of series is this? And more importantly, does this converge or not? Well, as we can see, we have the negative 1 to the nth power, so this is going to make the whole thing alternating, right? And then for this part right here, 1 over n plus 1. You see, this is n to the first power, and if you would like, you can plug in 0 into the n here and things like that. And let me do that for you guys real quick. When you plug in 0 into this n, that n, the first term is going to be positive 1 times 1 over 1, so it's just 1. When you plug in n is equal to 1 into here, it's going to be minus, and then plugging 1 here, so you get 1 half. And then you just keep going, plugging 2 into this right here, it's going to be positive, so we add. Plugging 2 in here, you get 1 third. So once you write this down, you see 1 minus 1 half plus 1 third. And the next one is going to be minus 1 fourth, and then so on. It's alternating, and you see this right here are just the harmonic series, right? Because the bottom are just the natural numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. And alternating harmonic series converges, right? So I can just tell you guys that this right here converges at x equals to negative 1 because b slash c stands for because the alternating harmonic, make it capital letter, series converges, right? So I can come to here and tell you guys that I will put a bracket like this, because we know when x is equal to negative 1, it's good, because that will make this power series converges, right? And we will have to check 3, and let's go ahead and do that right here. So let me put this down. We are going to check when x is equal to 3. So do the same thing, plugging 3 into that x. We will have the series when n goes from 0 to infinity, 2 to the negative n over n plus 1 times 3 minus 1 to the nth power, like that. Okay, this is the same as series when n goes from 0 to infinity. Write this down as 1 over 2 to the n times n plus 1, just like that, right? And in this case here, we only have 3 minus 1, which is just a positive 2 inside, right? And then we put this down as 2, and then to the nth power, like that. In this situation, you see that after we cancel 2 to the n and 2 to the n, that's all we have. And you have this, the series when n goes from 0 to infinity, positive 1 over n plus 1. And you can do the same thing, plugging 0 into here, and then you get 1, and then the next one is going to be 1 half, and the next one is 1 third, and then so on. Well, this is not alternating anymore. This is the harmonic series. But you know the regular one, the original harmonic series, diverges, right? So in this case, I will tell you guys that this diverges at x equals to positive 3. And once again, because we know that the original harmonic series diverges, right? Okay, so now I can come here. I don't want to include 3, because at x equals to 3, it diverges. So I'll put down a parenthesis like that. Okay, so that's pretty much it. The radius of convergence is 2. But if you want to, let me just write it down right here for you guys. For this, the radius of convergence was 2. And then the interval of convergence is from negative 1, and you include negative 1 to positive 3, but you do not include 3. So this right here is it.